Once upon a time, in a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind. But then, one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose to return for shelter from the bitter cold. Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away. But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances. The youth was found, and when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal. But it was too late, for she had seen that there was no love in his heart. As punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast and placed a powerful spell on the castle and all lived. Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle, with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world. The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years. If he could learn to love another, and earn their love in return, by the time the last petal fell, then the spell would be broken. If not, you'd be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope. For who could ever learn to love? A beast.
Bonjour!
She goes and turns so bad, Julia. I wonder if she.
I'm afraid she's rather odd.
You're different from the rest of us.
She's nothing like the rest of us. Yes, different from the rest of us.
My daughter, odd. Now, are you, my dear ever seen.
Except one uncle who, well, maybe let that pass. In all you say or do, you couldn't make it plainer. You are your mother's daughter, therefore you are class.
So I should just accept and see me not like them.
They are the conquerors, and you can take my word. You are unique, friend, day, long, friend. No matter what you do, I'm on your side. And if my point of view is somewhat misty-eyed, there's nothing clearer in my life than what I wish and feel for you. And that's a lot, no matter what. No matter what the pain, we've come this far. I pray that you remain exactly as you are. This really is a case of father knowing best.
And daughter too.
You're never strange.
Don't ever change.
You're all. Place it right up front. Stand back, Bev. Here it goes.
Oh, it works, Papa. You did it. And you'll win first prize at the fair tomorrow.
Who knows? Maybe I will at that.
Oh, I almost forgot. I made you this scarf for good luck.
Now I know, Alwyn. You won't be able to leave this town to visit all the places you learned about in your books. Well, I'm off, Bev.
All right, Papa.
It's quite my best invention, so simple yet complex, so massive yet so small. This triumph of design will be my old age pension. That is provided I can find the fair at all. I must have missed a sign. I should have paid attention. That's not a nightingale, and not a mating call.
Help! Help! Please! Somebody help me! Help! Help! Please!
unfortunate specimen. You could not leave him for the wolves.
Is somebody here?
If we keep quiet, maybe he'll go away.
Is anybody home?
Not one word, Lumiere, not one word.
I don't mean to be rude, it's just that I lost my way in the woods and I need a place to stay.
Oh, poor fellow. Oh, Cartwright, have a heart. Monsieur, you're welcome here.
I hope that. I know there's someone here and I'll make you step out where I can see you.
Hello?
Oh, and goodbye. Wait. You're what? And astonishing, isn't it? And quite inexplicable. Goodbye.
Oh, Cartwright, I'm surprised at you. Where are your manners?
We've got to get him out of here before the master finds out. This is incredible. How is this accomplished? Sir, do you want? My mind stopped. Must be some sort of new scientific gadget.
I, sir, not a gadget.
Well, I don't mean to be rude, it's just that I've never seen it. Bless you.
You are chilled to the bone, monsieur. Come, warm yourself by the fire.
No, I forbid it. Lumiere is in the household. I demand you stop right there.
Oh, no, not the master's chair. I'm not saying this.
Ooh la la, what have we here? Do my eyes deceive me or is it a man? Oh, it's been so long since I've seen a real man. No, Miss Lumiere. Bonjour, monsieur. Mind if I sit here?
Oh, why hello. All right, this has gone far enough. I'm in charge here.
How would you like a nice cup of tea, sir? Warm you up in no
tea. No tea. He'll be here all night. No tea.
There you are.
Thank you. This is just an
I think I scared him, Mama.
Now, what's your name, little fella?
Chip.
Figures.
Careful of the ladies, monsieur. I just love older men.
Babette, you always strive to make visions. Well, it will not affect this time.
Me, what about you? With Simone?
Jacques.
Michel?
Pierre.
Veronique.
Yeah. Oh, listen to me. We've got to get him out of here before the master finds out. Do you have any idea what the master will do if we found out we let a stranger in?
Oh, calm yourself, Cartwright. The master will never have to know. Yes, I must say, he's bound to find out sooner or later.
Should we hide, Mama?
No. Mendel, there's absolutely no reason to
panic. You'll be all right. There's absolutely no reason to panic.
Nevertheless.
A stranger here!
Master, allow me to explain. The gentleman was sent upon my wound.
Who let him in?
Oh, Master, may I take this opportunity to say that I was against it from the start?
Who dared to disobey me?
Oh, dear.
You've all betrayed me! Who are you?
Morris.
What are you doing in my castle?
I lost my way in the woods, and I...
You're welcome here! Come to stare at the beast, haven't you?
I meant no harm. I must be looking for a place to stay.
I'll give you a place to stay.
Thank you. just full of surprises for you, mademoiselle.
A miniature portrait of you! You shouldn't have.
Don't mention it. You know, there isn't a girl in town who would love to be in your shoes right now. This is the day all your dreams come true.
Oh, what could you possibly know about my dreams, Gaston?
Plenty!
Can you believe it?
again.
No, don't you understand? Something could have happened. You have to take me back.
Not a new life!
But I'll find you myself.
Couldn't keep quiet, could we? Just had to invite him in, didn't we? Serve him tea, sit in the master's chair, pet the pooch.
I was trying to be hospitable.
Rubbish.
Oh, Cogsworth, can you blame me for trying to maintain what's left of our humanity? Look at us. Look at you.
What about you?
You always were insolent, but every day you become just a little more inflexible, a little more tightly wound. A little more ticked off.
Oh, spare them, stupid puns.
At least we're not as vulgar as some of the others. You saw what happened to Michelle.
Oh, she was always too vain about her looks, and that's exactly what she's become.
A vanity.
There's drawers, mirrors, and works.
And poor Jean-Claude.
Who?
Jean-Claude, you remember him? Not too bright. Dumb as
a brick.
The whole wall.
Jean-Claude's a brick wall.
That's him in the kitchen, behind the stove. You know J.A.M, the houseboy?
That mealy-mouthed little bootlicker. I never liked him in the first place. He was always groveling at the master's feet.
He's a doormat.
Perfect.
It's happening faster with some of the others, but we are not far behind. Slowly, but surely, as every day passes, we will all gradually become things.
Yes, but why did we have to get dragged into this whole spell business? It's not like we threw the poor old beg woman out of there.
No. But are we not responsible, too, for making him the way he is?
I suppose.
All I know is I will eventually melt away into nothing. I will hope there's something left of me when the master breaks the spell.
Hold on, old man. You've got to hold on.
Hello? Is anyone here? Hello?
Eat again?
Yes, I'm not stupid. I can see it's again.
It's again! Mademoiselle!
Hello, Mian. Have you do all the talking?
You!
If he asks in the household, I should do most of the talking.
Chérie!
Just a word, just one word!
Mama, Mama! You're not gonna believe what I saw! Not in a million thousand years! Not in a trillion million thousand years!
Yes, dear.
No, really! It's the greatest thing! It's a thing everybody's been waiting for since I don't know when.
All right, Chip, what is it?
There's a girl in the castle.
Well, bless my soul, wouldn't that be lovely?
But there is. I saw her.
Now, Chip, I'll not have you making up wild stories, getting everyone's hopes up for no reason.
Mrs. Potts, there's a girl in the castle.
See, I told you, and she's real pretty, too.
Well, I don't know about that.
Oh, this is the one! The girl we've been waiting for. Oh, she's come to break the spell.
Wait a minute, let's not be hasty.
After all these years. Oh, happy, happy day!
Amir, stop, stop that!
We should tell the others, no?
Yes, I mean, wait a minute!
This castle!
See, you're the one responsible for this. Release my father,
Clark! I am the master of this castle! I don't take orders from anyone! Throw her out!
No! No, wait, please! Get to save that relic! Go!
He should not interest us!
But he's an old man, he can die!
He came into my home uninvited! I now must suffer the consequences.
Please! I'll do anything!
Well, there's nothing you can do!
No, wait, please!
I said there's nothing you can do!
Take me instead!
No!
Yes, but you must promise to stay here forever.
No! No!
Forever! He dies in the dungeon! Make your choice.
Please, Bear, listen to me. I'm old. I've lived my life.
You have my word.
Do it!
No.
No. No. Please. Please.
Wait,
I'm...
Please.
Take him to the crossroads!
Please.
No, wait, wait. Not yet.
Let her
please.
Go.
Please.
Let her
please.
Go. Bear. Bear!
That's him. That's him. Perhaps, since the girl is going to be with us for quite some time, you might want to offer her in a more comfortable room.
You didn't let me say goodbye.
What?
I'll never see him again, and you didn't even let me say goodbye!
I'll show you to your room.
My room?
Do you want to stay in the dungeon forever?
No.
Then follow. You follow me!
like some tea. Nothing like a nice, warm cup of tea to make the world seem a bit brighter.
But you...
Mrs. Potsdam, very pleased to make your acquaintance.
Oh, careful, darling! Who are you?
Madame de la Grande Bouche.
Perhaps you've heard of me?
Sorry.
You see? You can be, and I quote, the toast of Europe, the brightest star to ever grace the stage. And then you fall under one little spell.
And this is impossible.
Well, I know it is, darling, but, yeah, here we are. So, let's see. What shall we dress you in for dinner? This is nice. But how would you like to wear one of my gowns? Let me see what I've got in my drawers. Oh, dear, not those. That's so embarrassing. Oh, what about this? I wore this the night I performed at the Royal Grand Opera. The king himself was there. Of course, I wouldn't have a prayer of fitting into it now. Take it.
It's very kind of you, but I'm not going to dinner.
Don't be silly. Of course you are. You heard what the master said. He may be your master, but he's not mine.
But no, I'm sorry. This is all just happening so fast.
That was a very brave thing you did, my dear.
We all think so. I'm going to miss my father so much.
Cheer up, child. It'll turn out all right in the end. You'll see. I hope that we'll be friends, though I don't know you well. If anyone can make the most of living here, then well, it's you.
Yes, that's incredibly thick. Yeah!
What?
Just about. I haven't the foggiest idea on what she likes to eat, so I've cooked up everything in the kitchen.
Good, good. Don't just stand there gaping about it. Get back to work.
You tell him.
I can't.
Tell me what?
Now, don't get upset. But you got something on your back.
Look here, what on earth are you talking about?
What on earth is this? Well, it appears to be a winding handle of sorts.
Oh, just stand there, get it off me!
It won't come off!
What do you mean it won't come off? It wasn't there last night when I went to bed. Why on earth is this happening to me?
It's the spell, I'm afraid.
You just try to relax.
Relax? How can I relax with the appendages in my back?
Oh, calm down, it will be all right.
Let me ask for us.
Oh, I know, my friend. But you are not alone.
We're all in this together.
Time for dinner. Where is she?
Perhaps I should go see. Won't be able to.
I told her to calm down! What is taking so long?
Try to be patient, sir. The girl has lost her father and her friend more than one day.
Well, Master, have you thought that perhaps this girl could be the one to break the spell?
Well, of course I have. Not a fool.
Good. So you fall in love with her, she falls in love with you, and poof, the spell is broken. We'll be human again in no time.
Really? Yeah, it's not that easy.
But we don't have time. The rose has already begun to wilt.
It's no use. She's so beautiful, and I'm... Well, look at me.
He has a point.
Oh. Master, you must try and help us get past all that.
Well, how?
Well, you could start by trying to make yourself feel more presentable. Straighten up. Try to act like a gentleman.
Impress her with your impudence, but be gentle.
Shower her with compliments.
But be sincere. And above all,
what?
You must control your temper.
What?
Where is she?
Oh, yes, the girl. Well, she's in the process of circumstances. She's not coming.
What did you say?
She's not coming. She's not coming.
She's not coming!
We'll see about that! I thought I told you to come down to dinner!
I'm not hungry!
I am the master of this castle, and I am telling you to come down to dinner!
And I'm telling you I'm not hungry!
You're hungry if I say you're hungry!
Oh, don't be ridiculous.
What did you say?
You can't go around ordering people to be hungry! It doesn't work that way! Besides, it's rude.
Oh, rude is it? Then how about this? I'll drag you by the hair!
Still, that may not be the best way to win the girl's affection.
At least attempt to be a gentleman.
Why is she being so difficult? Why are you being so difficult?
Why are you being such a bully?
Because I want you to come down to dinner.
So you admit being a bully.
Deep breath, Master, deep breath.
Would you be so kind as to join me for dinner? Please.
No, thank you.
Fine, then starve!
No, please.
If she doesn't eat with me, she doesn't eat.
What are we thinking? We will never be human again.
So it appears.
Well, what would you two have us do, give up? I can't give up until I hear the sound of my voice and after as he runs through these halls again.
Quite right, Miss Potts. We mustn't give up while there's still a chance. Lumiere, stand guard at the door if there's the slightest change in form at once.
Oui, mon capitaine.
That's the nice thing, but she refuses. What? What does she want me to do, Peg? Show me the girl.
Oh, I know the master can be slightly temperamental underneath all that matter of fur, but he's not such a bad fellow.
everybody. A monster? How long must this go on? This cruel trick of fate. I simply gave a careless wrong decision. And then that wish was gone and left me in this state. An object of revulsion and derision. Hated. Is there no one who can show me how to be the world's forgiveness? No. What did they say? Shower her with compliments. Dress her with your wit. Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentleman.
Culinary cavalry, our Lord, the stone, the battle Thank you.
What's that?
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
What are you doing here? I told you never to come here! Do you realize what you could have done? Get out! You had no right to be there, no right! I'm sorry. I didn't mean to frighten you. I didn't mean to hurt you. You don't understand. There's so little left of me. So little left.
No love. gave me my life.
Well, that's more like it. I knew they could get along if they tried.
So, the ice is broken at last.
Not a moment too soon, then. Have you taken a good look at the rose leaf? It's losing its petals after a long night.
Not to mention the fact that I can hardly bend over at all.
Klein, it's time we must give them a little push. No, we must find a nice romantic way to draw them closer together.
I've got just the thing. How about we warm you two up with a nice bowl of soup?
Soup?
Trust me.
Glance this way, I thought I saw. And when we touched, she didn't shudder at my paw. No, it can't be, I'll just ignore. But then she's never looked at me that way before. When she smiles at me, I get all choked up. My heart starts pounding and I can't breathe.
Good, good.
That's good.
Excellent.
I've never felt this way about anyone. I want to give her something. But what?
Well, actually, there's the usual things. Flowers, chocolates, promises you don't intend to keep.
No, no. This is no ordinary girl. It has to be something special. Something that sparks her interest. Something that...
What? Are you sure? It's pink. What a nice dress.
Thank you.
Bella, I have something to show you. But first you have to close your eyes. It's a surprise.
Well, it just so happens that this is perfect.
Maybe
beautiful story. What?
A second chance? Would you have dinner with me tonight?
Dinner? Me? With you? Oh, that'd be... Oh, yes!
Stage to convince you that you'll be.
Oh,
I'm not sure I can do that.
Oh, but you must.
More than anything.
Why not Delahair?
I can't.
But you must. Beautiful music, romantic candlelight, provided by us. When the moment is right.
Well, how will I know when the moment's right?
Well, actually, you feel slightly nauseous.
You know, as you really feel, you must speak from the heart.
I must speak from the... I can't.
You must. Master, what are you afraid of?
Nothing.
Master?
Well, I'm afraid she might...
She might what?
Laugh at me.
Somehow, my prince, you must find the courage to take that chance.
I really don't think I can do this.
Use my head towards the advantage. You can do it, Master. I know you can.
Thank you.
you for asking me to dinner.
Dinner was wonderful.
Del, I... Del, are you happy here?
Yes, everyone's so kind. Just spots in the air.
With... I must speak from
the heart.
Is something wrong?
Thank you.
crazier than that!
Tell me, Maurice, when did you first start having these?
Delusions.
It's not a delusion. The beast is real, and so is the talking clock.
Poor Belle. It's a shame about your father.
Gaston, you know my father's not crazy.
I may be able to clear up this little misunderstanding if...
If
you'll marry me. One little word, Belle. That's all it takes.
Never!
Have it your way! Take the old man!
No, wait, please! I can prove to you that my father's not crazy! Show me the beast!
Come on.
You look like you could use a nice cup of tea.
Thank you.
Here you go.
No! Take that, you scummy scum!
Hey! Where did everybody go?
into my eyes. Now don't you recognize the beast within the man who's here before you? Let's go find your father.
No. Thank you.